Welcome to my channel. My name is Candace Alanae, and by the title you already know, today we're going to be doing a curly to straight routine, how I get my hair super straight and silky like this, flowy, all of that. So if you want to know how I got my hair like this, keep watching because I promise you won't regret it. The first step to getting the straightest hair you can get is having a good wash and condition. This is the shampoo that I use. And this is the conditioner I use. This conditioner is really good for my hair color. It's the Fade Divine one, okay? The Fade Divine one. After you get a good wash and condition, the next step is to blow dry. And when I blow dry my hair, I just part it down the middle into two. And I take a ponytail holder to whichever side to get it, keep it out the way of the other sides. I comb it out so it can be a little bit easier when I go through with the blow dryer. And the brush that I'm using is Mitchell Mercier. This brush is so good. Oh my God, y'all, like, look. This is like the secret formula, okay? This right here, Paul Mitchell. Smoothest serum, okay? It's not even expensive. It's like $4. I don't know. I can't remember, but I know it's not expensive. And it gets my hair super straight. So get some of this, okay, sis? You only need like two pumps before your blow dry, so you can get a good blow dry, because blow drying is another key to success with getting extremely straight hair. So only two pumps, about this much on each side. You just take it from the root all the way down. And it's so lightweight, like, I promise y'all. It's not like an oil or nothing like that, because it doesn't weigh your hair down. I promise. You don't need the serum, okay? Because we have another trick up our sleeve to get it super straight. But after you put the serum in, you want to go ahead and blow dry your hair. I have this blow dryer right here. But I also have another one that doesn't have combs, and I use it all the time too. But this is easier. This is way easier for me. This blow dryer gets my hair as close to straight as it can before I actually straighten it. So, and I put it on high because it takes a long time for my hair to dry. Now that you're all blowed out, the next step is to section your hair into four pieces, because we're about to get into the flat ironing part. I like to take my comb and go all the way to the back down the middle and then across the side. So I'll have 1, 2, 3, 4. now that you have your hair into four parts and you look silly, we're gonna move on to flat ironing. And the flat iron I use is Remington. The Remington one. I just got this. It doesn't have a heat setting, but I guess it goes up to heat. Oh, I'm so stupid. I guess it goes up to like 400 degrees. And you don't want that. So I put it on the middle one, not the highest one. You're gonna need something to hold your hair up because it's gonna be everywhere while you flat iron it. It's gonna get annoying. So you might need a clip, another comb, bobby pin, whatever you wanna use to keep your hair up. So you want to part your first piece of hair. And when you do your parts, you don't need big fat parts or big thick parts because it's not gonna get as straight as you want it to be. The thinner the piece you straighten, the flatter it is. I'm telling you, if you try to flat iron a thick old piece, girl, your hair is gonna look poofy. Unless you just got really, really thin hair like that. This is like the second secret formula to getting the straightest hair ever. I look so crazy. But this is like the second secret formula to getting the straightest hair ever. It's the chasing method. And for the chasing method, you need a comb with like small, not wide gaps, little small tiny gaps. And of course your flat iron. And I first get my root. After I get my root, I take my comb and I put it underneath the hair and I hold it right there. Then I take my flat iron and I basically just chase the comb. And you wanna do it slowly so you won't have to go back over your hair again and damage it. And you see how straight that freaking piece of hair got? Look at that. Can y'all see that? Over one pass, only one pass. So you just wanna do the chasing method throughout your whole head, okay? And you're gonna look bomb, sis. after you're done with the hardest part and the part that takes the longest, you gotta get your parts together, so, cause this ain't it. It's not it. So I'm gonna do a middle part again. After you get that part, baby, I know you saw my edges. Woo! Woo! That is not cute. So we just gonna go in and fix our edges real quick. So freaking hard to do, cause I be trying not to hurt myself. But yeah. Okay, so after you get your edges, turn that bad boy out. I usually go in with one more pump over my hair just to make sure it's really shiny and cute. But you do not have to do this, okay? This is just my preference. And if you want to, you can go over one more time. But I usually don't do that because of heat damage purposes. But if you have some pieces like this front piece, I'm not liking it. So I'm just gonna go back over it and get it right and tight. And for a finishing touch, I like to go in to do my edges with this 24 hour edge tamer. This is cheap too. I got this for $1.99. at the beauty supply store. I do not do my edges when my hair is flat with Eco, because baby, it will curl your hair up. This keeps your hair straight. And I don't do it with a toothbrush either on my straight hair. I do it with a spoolie. Y'all know what that is. Yeah. So I just take a little bit. You do not need a lot. And I put it at the front. Ooh, girl, don't look at that bump. Not having a good day. PMS. And we gonna swoop that thing. We gonna swoop that thing like, yo. Yes, that just added a little spice. Hold on. So yeah, that's how I get my hair super straight and flowy. If you like this video, please like, comment, and subscribe, and turn on your post notifications, because I will be posting more even though I've been slacking. And make sure to comment other videos that you would like me to do, because I'd be having a hard time thinking of video ideas that you guys want to see, because I don't want to put out videos that y'all not going to watch, you know what I mean? All the products that I used in this video will be linked in the description below. And all of my social medias, my Instagram, my Twitter, and my Snapchat. I don't get on Twitter like that, but you can add me on there. And yeah, thank you for watching.